soon to become one of Malaysia's leading petrochemical companies. We employ a team of highly trained experts with considerable experience within the chemical industry. We also strive to provide industry-leading customer service and excellent values for your business. The main product from PlusChem is acrylonitrile. So let's have a look at the properties of acrylonitrile. Acrylonitrile is a colorless volatile liquid with chemical formula of C3H3N. It is an organic compound with a pungent smell. It is a reactive chemical that polymerizes spontaneously when heated or in the presence of a strong alkali. It can explode when exposed to flame and is incompatible with strong oxidizers and copper. Acrylonitrile serves as an important intermediate widely used in industry to produce rubber, resins, plastics, elastomers, and synthetic fibers. These end products are widely found in our daily life. The primary end use of acrylonitrile is in the production of copolymers such as acrylonitrile butadiene styrene ABS, styrene acrylonitrile SAN, acrylonitrile styrene acrylate ASA, and other synthetic rubbers. The second largest uses is for production of acrylic fibers in textile industries, followed by acrylamide production, which is used in wastewater treatment as flocculants. Acrylonitrile is also a precursor for acrylic acid through hydrolysis process and for adiponitrile by electrodimerization process. Acrylonitrile is used as a monomer to produce polyacrylonitrile used in the production of carbon fiber. Customers in the surrounding Southeast Asia. Market analysis was made and it shows that Asia had accounted for 70% of the total market of acrylonitrile. In year 2015, the global supply and demand are 7,200 and 5,400 kilotons respectively. Consistent overcapacity are seen throughout the years due to relatively stable trade flows among regions. The demand is expected to increase at a CAGR of 3.95%, driven by ABS resins industry reaching capacity of 8,700 kilotons in 2030. The supply is expected to increase at a rate of 1.2%, reaching 8,300 kilotons in 2030. Tongsu Petrochemicals in South Korea leads the acrylonitrile market with the largest capacity of 560 kilotons, followed by Ineos Nitriles in America and Jilin Petrochemical in China. Our plant operates at a capacity of 126 kilotons per annum, which caters about 3% of Asia's consumption. The price of acrylonitrile in 2017 ranged from 5.50 ringgit to 7.80 ringgit per unit kilogram. Process of acrylonitrile. Acrylonitrile will be produced through catalytic vapor phase amoxidation of propylene, which is known as the Sohio process. The process can be divided into three main sections, which are the amoxidation section, absorption and recovery section, and also purification section. During amoxidation, propylene and ammonia are mixed and fed into a fluidized bed reactor R101. Air is fed into the reactor separately. The reactor operates at a temperature of 450 degrees Celsius and at a pressure of 2 bar with bismuth molybdenum oxide as the catalyst. The conversion of propylene to acrylonitrile is 98% with selectivity of 83%. The byproducts formed are acetonitrile, hydrogen cyanide, and CO2. Cooling coils are immersed in the fluidized bed due to the highly exothermic reaction. The main reaction occurring in R101 is the production of acrylonitrile, followed by side reactions producing hydrogen cyanide, acetonitrile, and carbon dioxide. During absorption and recovery section, the hot reactor effluent is quenched with water in a scrubber D101, and unreacted ammonia is neutralized with sulfuric acid of 35% weight in mixer M101. Off gases which are not absorbed by the water containing nitrogen, carbon dioxide, and unreacted propylene will be sent to the incinerator. The liquid mixture is then sent to fractionator column D102 to separate crude acrylonitrile from acetonitrile. The crude acrylonitrile stream containing hydrogen cyanide are produced as top product. The bottom product of D102 containing acetonitrile and water is sent to acetonitrile recovery column D103 to recover acetonitrile as top product and water as the bottom product. The bottom product is then sent to the crystallizer C101 to obtain purified ammonium sulfate crystals as fertilizer. In purification section, extractive distillation column is used to separate hydrogen cyanide as top product, which will then be stored in liquid form. The bottom product consisting of acrylonitrile and heavy ends is sent to acrylonitrile purifying column T102. In T102, acrylonitrile is recovered as top product with a purity of 99.5%, whereas the bottom product containing water and traces of acrylonitrile and acetonitrile is sent to wastewater treatment.
Environmental safety is a vital concern during the production of acrylonitrile. Byproducts form should be handled according to the Local Environment Act and disposed properly. Operation of the plant will abide by the Environmental Quality of Clean Air Regulation 2014, Environmental Quality Industrial Effluent Regulation 2009, and Occupational Safety and Health Act 1994. The main byproducts form hydrogen cyanide and acetonitrile will be sold. Hydrogen cyanide are useful in applications such as fumigation, electroplating, and synthetic fiber production. Acetonitrile is used in manufacturing of pharmaceuticals, perfumes, rubber products, and pesticides. A biological treatment plant is used to reduce the concentration in wastewater up to permissible discharge level. The wastewater is first pumped into an anoxic tank, followed by an aeration tank. Denitrification occurs in anoxic tank. Activated sludge present in aeration tank enables the degradation of acrylonitrile and acetonitrile to occur. The effluent will then be sent to a sedimentation tank. Excess sludge and nitrified effluent will be recycled to the anoxic tank. The treated effluent is then safe to be discharged. Proper handling and storage of chemicals are practiced in our plant. All of the chemicals are stored in tightly sealed container and well-ventilated areas. Storage tanks are surrounded by a concrete dike. Acrylonitrile, acetonitrile, and hydrogen cyanide are stored in liquid form away from fire hazard and oxidizing agents. Polymerization inhibitors are added to acrylonitrile storage. We pay special attention to the safety of our workers. Proper PPE are required when handling those chemicals. PlusChem is accredited to ISO 9001 and ISO 14001. We invite all of our customers to visit our site and audit our facilities to ensure that we are the best fit for their need. We also adopt a lean culture in PlusChem to ensure continued improvement in everything we do. If you'd like to find out more about our manufacturing capabilities, please get in contact with us. Give us a call and you can find out more on our website. And lastly, thank you for taking the time to watch this video and we look forward to working with you.